Hello student, today myself Kalpana Singh, your bio teacher, make a video on a topic that I have taken from class 10th biology chapter, that is heredity and evolution. It's a very important chapter, that is the, you can say, the basic chapter related to genetics. This time, as because of the COVID pandemic, the syllabus has been reduced. Actually, chapter name is heredity and evolution, but this time it is reduced and only the heredity part is coming. So today I'll make a video on heredity topic. Almost we can say they make the chapter half. Evolution they just cancel. So this time only heredity part, and related to that heredity section, I'll just going to explain the, I mean, who is the founder or who is the person that, you know, give this term genetics, how it comes and what it is related to, and what are the laws related to it, and what are the other things, important things related to this heredity section. Now, what is heredity? So if you will go through the definition regarding this term, so heredity is the process of passing traits or characteristics from parents to offspring. Characteristics means characters. Traits and characteristics are the same thing. So you don't get to confuse, both are same. That means, if we are talking about humans, so we have the, first generation, then the second, and this is how it moves on generation to generation, and for the, continuation of the species. Like, so some of the characters that are passes from the parents to offspring, that are called heredity characters. So we don't have to get confused what is characteristics and what is traits. Both are same. If you write trait, then it will fine. If you write characteristic, that means it is also fine. You don't have to get confused. So that is means the certain characters that passes, or the process that in which the traits or the characteristics passes from parents to offspring. This is called heredity. We have some features related to our father. Some features we get from our mother. And some features, yes, we can say ki we get from our forefathers. Sometime happen ki offsprings are, or the new ones or the babies are not resembling their parents, but yes, they are resembling their forefathers. Anyhow, it has been related to it. We'll discuss later on regarding that. So first of all, we have to understand what is heredity. The very simple description regarding that, the characteristics or the traits that are passes from the parents to the next generation, to the offspring, or we can say progeny, that is called heredity. Offsprings, the newborn of their parents, and newborns, co-offsprings, we can say. And progeny, I suppose, that is another name to the offspring. So we can say progeny, we can say offspring, we can say the babies. Technical term is the progeny and offsprings. So this is all about heredity. Now, if you are talking about the humans, okay, because that is the best example that we are familiar to. So humans, if we are talking about, obviously mother, father of the family, and with the contribution in the sexual concept, the baby formed or the offspring formed. Now the baby so formed of the mother and father, few characters it comes from the mother's side and few characters comes from the father's side, and this is how the mingling or the variation occur in the baby. This is heredity. Few characters from the father, few from the mother, that enters in the body of the baby during the, the development in the fetal section, that is called the heredity part. It's very easy to understand. Now the features match with the parents maximum. Heredity may kahi, in this section if we are talking about maximum features that is received from the mother or the father, few of the characters we can say we get it from the forefather. It's very rare, but it happens ki some of the, in some cases offsprings are not at all resembling their parents. parents. But instead of parents, they resemble their grandparents, right? So what kind of characters? Like if we just think about it, so yes, we can say the eyes of the eyes color, maybe the black, maybe the blue, maybe the brown, or the skin tone color, fair complexion or the dark complexion, hai na? And then another example of the that is the inheritance, that is the height of the offspring. So they are these are some of the examples that shows that the we get the characteristics or traits from our father. That is called heredity. Now, traits or characters. Two type of traits or characters are there, basically. That is inherited characters or traits and the acquired traits. As you can understand or the terms clear very finely, inherited means that we received or inherit, that we get from our parents. That is inherited. And acquired means that we attain throughout our lifespan. So that is the huge difference. So first we just explains the inherited traits. Inherited traits, traits that transferred from parents. That is the section of the heredity. So what are inherited traits? Means by birth. We get these traits or characters by birth. Okay. And example, like the height of the offspring, maybe the tall or maybe the normal height or below normal height, that all depends on the genes that we receive from our parents. Another example is the color of the skin, maybe the fair complexion or maybe the dark complexion that we inherited. That are the inherited traits that we get from our parents. Or another example is the skin tone, color of the eyes and the height. These are some very common examples that we can give in this section. Another point related to inherited characters, present in genes, genetic. See, only the characters that are present in genes are forwarded to the or carry out with, in the next generation. The characters that are not infected or we can say ki present in the genes are not carried out or not forwarded to the next generation. As inherited traits we get from the parents, definitely they are present in the genes. That is why they are forwarded to the next generation, to the next, to next, to next, carry out. Another point, variations that occur in the reproductive tissues. Variations means the variety. See, in the right another chapter of the class 10, that is a reproduction, we just gone through the sexual and asexual reproduction, and it is very much clear that variation brings only through the sexual reproduction, and for the sexual reproduction two parents are required, female or male, or we can say mother and father. So of course if we are talking about the humans, we are talking about the sexual reproduction. That means because it is a part of the reproductive tissue, traits or heredity, it is forwarded to the next generation or to the offsprings or to the progeny. So this is all about the inherited trait that are transferred from the parents, present in the genes. That means we can say it is genetic. Then the variations that occur in the reproductive tissue. Reproductive tissue, that you know, that is a part of reproduction, sexual reproduction, and that is in which the few of the genes we get from the mother and few from the father. So of course it is the part of reproductive tissue, that is it, that is why it is inherited traits. Another section, that is acquired traits, acquired that we attain or that we receive after the birth, that we didn't get from our parents, no, that we achieve during our life period. First of all, traits that develop after birth in life. That means once we come in this on this earth, we planet, so when we grow up, maybe accidentally or maybe gradually, such speciality or things we get that makes us, you know, different from the others. That is called the acquired traits. Now, what are the examples of acquired traits? If we are laborious, hardworking, so with the hard work, we may get the better education. Maybe we become doctor or engineer or something else. So that is our achievement that we didn't get from the parents. Would it be possible, doctors, doctor, if the parents are doctor, both are doctor or any one of the parent is doctor, so could it be possible ki their offsprings will definitely be a doctor? No, because it is not inherited. I mean, these things we attain, we achieve after the birth. So that is an example. That means attaining knowledge or the hobbies. If a person is expert in, you know, in guitar or any other instrument, musical instrument, or maybe in singing, or maybe in other activity, that is it's his or her achievement that he get from, by his own effort, not from the parents' contribution, right? So such examples are the examples of acquired trait. Now, the hobbies, attaining knowledge, learning music, etc. are some of the examples of the acquired traits. Second point related to it, not present in the genes. That is why it is not inherited to next generation. These are somatic. Somatic means that are not related to the genes. Traits that are related to genes that are, you know, carry out in the next generation. That is a part of heredity. But the characters or the traits that are not related to the genes, they are limited to that person only. They are not forwarded to the next generation, to its offspring. So that are the part of acquired trait. Now, last point. Occurs in the non-reproductive tissues. Obviously, that is why it is not inherited. That is limited to a person's life only. So these are the important point of differentiation that makes a difference between inherited traits and acquired trait. So first of all, we gone through heredity. What is heredity? With the example of the human, of the mother and father, we understand. And then we says ki yes, traits are after two type. Inherited traits and acquired trait. One more thing that is very important. Earlier, for a very long time, the heredity term is also called as inheritance for a very long time. But now it is called heredity. So that is an important thing. Heredity also called inheritance for a long time. But presently it is called heredity, very technical term to it. So this is related to it. Now, one more thing that has to be highlighted over here in this chapter, heredity, is that, I mean, there is a lot of confusion how the genes or what are the genes or what are the traits related to the genes that are, you know, carry forward to the next generation. It is very easy to say, but very difficult to understand if we don't know what is heredity and what are the details, what are the, you know, study material. We don't have, earlier we don't have the related, theoretical section. Study material regarding these topics. So very difficult to understand. So one person is there that is responsible for clear out all the confusions related to the traits that are inherited to the next parents. What are inheritance? What are the characters? What are the genes? So one person was there that is known as the father of inheritance, and that is the Gregor John Mendel. And his lifespan is very short, that is 1822 to 1884. Very short lifespan he had. So Gregor John Mendel was basically an Austrian monk. And he was, you know, live in a church. And earlier church has a very, you know, very big span, very large area of land, an isolated person, you know, isolated from the public or the, daily routine things. So he was very fond of studies. But he has the limitation because he was the monk. So what he did, he just get some books and other things related to the, you know, bio and all. And he keeps on studying. and after that he used to think about what is genes and whatever, and then he start doing experiment on a plant, and from that section, from experiments, he got the concept of the heredity, and he just make notes related to, and he did a lot of work of 25 to 30 years of work, lot of experiments, and he had given three laws related to the heredity. But unfortunately, that time, because it was all manually, what the work, the research work or whatever that has done manually, computer wasn't there at that time. So he had submitted his all theories to a particular department, and came back to that his monastery because he was a monk. But and after that he just passed away, because as I've told you, 1822 to 84, very short lifespan. So he didn't get any criteria for his work during his life, and after his death, it has been analyzed. He has given a very perfect material or his research paper, and after that, after his death, he just get the credit of this heredity, and for that he is known as to be the father of the genetics. He is given this criteria, and Gregor John Mendel today and earlier also and forever known as the father of inheritance. But unfortunately, he didn't enjoy his this thing. The respect that has been given for his work, he didn't enjoy that. He all get all this after his death. So whatever, the theory of inheritance was cleared by Gregor John Mendel. He was an Austrian monk, father of inheritance. He was known as father of inheritance. And that brings the probability section is biology. Probability section, probability is a mathematical part. And we know very well, bio is a subject in which everything is there. Theory is there, related diagrams are there, but there is no mathematical portion. But he was the person that brings not the exact complete probability section of the maths, but a slight section of the probability. He introduced the mathematical portion in the bio in the topic heredity. So he is also given credit for this thing. So he brings the probability section of the mathematics in the biology. And Mendel, whatever experiment he done, that all done on the garden pea. What is the scientific name of the garden pea plant? That is the Picum sativum. This is very important to remember. What is the scientific name of the garden pea plant? It has been asked in the board for one marks. So you have to remember this name, that is Picum sativum. So he had selected garden pea because of certain reasons. And what are their reasons for his experiment? That are the reasons. Number one, it was easy to grow. Garden pea plant, as pea word, you can understand related to the pea. But it is not the pea plant, normal pea plant that is grown for getting the peas in the winters. Garden pea plant is a kind of ornamental plant. Of course, the pods are there, peas are there, but that is not for the commercial use or for the food, not used as a food. It is used as an ornamental plant because it has numerous variety of the colors of the flowers, and it has been grown in the garden for the flowers only, not for getting the peas. So that is why specifically it has been said that Mendel has chosen the garden pea plant for his experiment. And what is the scientific name of the garden pea plant? That is Picum sativum. It is very important. The first reason why he has selected garden pea plant, that is, it has easy to grow. Garden pea plant can be grown anywhere in this world very easily. It doesn't require any special attention or any specific kind of soil. No, it has been grown easily worldwide. The first reason is that garden pea plant was easy to grow. Second, short life span cycle and so possible to study number of generation. Suppose Mendel choose humans for his experiment, so how much generation he studied? On an average, if we can say a person has an average life of 60 years, although he has a very short span of life, as I've already told you, so how much generation he observe in humans? Hardly two or three. I mean the four, the grandparents, then the parents, then the offspring. Not more than that. But that is not sufficient, for his work. He has to study a lot of generation. And garden pea plant is a plant that has a very short lifespan. And he, because of that, he can study a lot of generation related to his experiment. So second point, why he has selected? See, these three points are very important because question of 3 marks can be asked. Why Mendel choose garden pea plant for his experiment? The first, it is easy to grow. Second thing, garden pea plant has a life short cycle. And because of that, it is possible to study number of generations. That is not possible in any other case. Third point, it has 7 pairs of contrasting characters. Very important. Garden pea plant have the contrasting characters 7. More than that, it could be possible, not less than 7. So that is very much helpful in the study of the heredity characters by the Mendel. That is why he had chosen the garden pea plant for his experiment. It is a very important question, I'm telling you. So two important question, two kya, so many questions have been asked. How you can define heredity? Yeah, what is heredity? 1 marks question. Then how many type of traits are there? Write the difference between inherited and acquired traits. That must be of 2 or 3 numbers. Then, who is known as the father of inheritance or father of genetics? Gregor John Mendel. Regarding his history, life history, question hasn't been asked. But who is known as the father of genetics? Why Mendel choose the garden pea plant for his experiment? And what is the scientific name of the garden pea plant? Such questions has been asked. So now after that, what are the 7 pairs of contrasting characters? Contrasting means opposite, totally opposite characters, right? So what 7 characters a garden pea plant have? So let's study that. First is the seed color. 2 type of seed he found in garden pea plant. Seed color. What are these? Yellow, green. Then second character, seed shape. What are the shapes of the seed? 2 type of the shapes. Round, that is normal. Round you can understand. And another contrasting is wrinkled. Wrinkled means a bit crushed one. Then third is the flower color. What are the colors of the flower? So many colors I have told you. So he can choose any 2 contrasting colors. For the flower, purple and white. Then the flower position. 2 type positions are there. Axial position and the terminal position. Axial means on the sides. That is called the axial position of the flower. And terminal means on the top, tip of the plant. So 2 type of the flower position, that is axial and terminal. Then the height of the plant. 2 type of the height, tall plant or the dwarf plant. Dwarf means short-heighted, tall to normal tall. Then the pod shape, 2 type of shapes are there, inflated, and contrasting to the inflated is the constricted. And the last 7th contrasting feature, character is the pod color. Pod color may green and yellow. So 2 type of your contrasting 7 characters he found, Mendel found in the pea plant. So that I have written over here, that you can note it down. It is very important. And if I make a section over here, so the first, that means that are written on the left hand side, all are the dominant characters or the traits. And that are written on the right hand side are the recessive traits or character. Dominant means what? Dominant means the ruling character. If both the characters come together, then the ruling one, the dominant one, always hide the recessive one. Recessive means the characters that hide. Hide by what? Hide by the ruling character, that is the dominant character. So, left hand side, all the dominant character. Right hand side, all the recessive character. Dominant and recessive. This I'll explain what are they later on. So, these are the seven characters that has been found in the garden pea plant. It's again very important, name the seven characters that the Mendel found in the garden pea plant. So, we have seen the dominant and recessive traits. So, now I'll explain these traits, the dominant trait and the recessive trait. Now, what are the dominant traits? Dominant traits express itself in the presence or absence of the recessive traits. That means if the recessive traits are present, then it will be fine. Or if the recessive traits are absent, then it will be fine. Then in both the cases, dominant trait expresses itself. So it expresses itself in the presence or absence of the recessive traits. That means the presence or absence of the recessive traits means nothing for the dominant. The expression of the dominant trait. On the other hand, recessive traits expresses itself only in the absence of dominant trait. That means recessive traits expresses only when the dominant trait is altogether absent. In that condition, recessive trait becomes the dominant trait and expresses itself. Otherwise, it always used to hide itself. For example, this we can understand with the one character, that is the tallness. As we have gone through the seven traits or characters by the, shown by the garden pea plant. So here we have taken one of the character, that is the tallness of the plant. As we have said in the beginning of the video, in the sexual, because it is genetic trait, so one from the father, one from the mother, then the offspring forms, right? So in plant section also process is the same. So that means one character, maybe the tall one comes from the father, one comes from the mother. Maybe it may be possible, three cases can be formed. One character from the female, maybe the capital T. Capital T refers to the dominant trait. And from the male section also, capital T, tall. Trait will become. So in that case, when from both the parents tall character or trait has been come, then the offspring or the next generation, all the plants are tall in this case, right? In second case, suppose the male from the male section, capital T, tall trait will come, and from the female, another parent, the dwarf trait has been there. So two type of variety of the traits we have, tall and dwarf, right? Here one is dominant and recessive is also present, but here again in the next generation plants will be tall because dominant capital T is present. What is there? Dominant trait expresses itself in the presence or absence of the recessive trait. Here, recessive trait is altogether absent. Plant is tall. Here, recessive trait is present. But even then, plant is tall, next generation. Now, the third situation case, when from the male recessive character tall, the dwarf trait is there, and from the female, again, the dwarf trait is there. When dominant trait is altogether absent, in this case only, the plant will be dwarf. recessive trait expresses itself only in the absence of dominant trait. In this section, third case, dominant trait is altogether absent. In this case only, the next generation plant, all the plants will be dwarf. So, with the example of tallness, we can understand the dominant and recessive trait. So, this is all for today. In the next generation, I'll just explain the important terms related to the heredity chapter and the monohybrid cross and dihybrid crosses, homozygous and heterozygous. And the in the last, the summary of the Mendel's principle. This year, no details has been asked related to the Mendel's law. Only the summary they have been asked because the aapka syllabus is reduced. And in the last, I'll just explain the sex determination in human. This will be the last topic of this chapter, that is heredity. So I'll explain all this topic in the next video. Thank you, students.